April 27th, 1993. Apollo speaking. When I was a child, I thought I was the only one gifted with a conscious inner dialogue, and that everyone else was only capable of acknowledging their immediate surroundings. I then believed for some time that the Earth was some sort of grand construction made only for me, and that everyone else are mere spawns put here to simply populate the world, my world, and tried to convince me this is all real. Of course, I made the mistake of proposing this theory to my primary school teacher, mainly to see how she'd react to me figuring out the master plan. Part of me expected her to malfunction or maybe even explode. She didn't. Instead, she sent me to a shit for brains counselor who tried to tell me I'm all confused. Nevertheless, it made me realize she was partly correct. These people don't have the capacity to pull something like that off. I was right the first time. This world is riddled with mindless puppets, slowly but surely destroying the human race and undoing centuries of progress. They're a plague, and I was put here to cure it. So that's what I started to do. I reside in the West Wing of my recently deceased father's estate, consuming the finest aged Cabernet Sauvignon and Pinot Noir his extravagant wine cellar has to offer. One of the perks of your father being an upper-class alcoholic. It's quiet out here. No intruders, no nagging wives, no drunken floozies. I can focus on what I was put on this earth to do, eradicate those who...
Hi there, I'm Kai Bald. I'm the executive of Mr. Hans Beckett's estate. I was sent here to go through the files he keeps hoarded in his old office. You must be his son. I'm sorry for your loss.
He was an abusive alcoholic. Kai C.W. Bald. Now, who names their daughter Kai C.W. Bald?
My parents, apparently. My family are Estonian. They're a big fan of giving women short boyish names and really going overboard with the middle names. It's technically Kai C.W.W. Bolt, but I didn't want to pay extra for the printing. Nevertheless, can I?
First door on your left.
Once belonged to Henry VI. We're distant relatives of his.
The Mad King?
In the case of my father. I guess you could say it runs in the family.
So I don't know whether your mother informed you of this, but it's going to take me a couple of days to go through everything. Your father had a lot of files.
Yes, we have a lot of money.
Sleep on the sofa in the study. I won't be an issue. I'll be sure to stay out of your hair.
I thought you were staying out of my hair.
Once, a girl isn't allowed a cigarette after spending 6 straight hours reviewing a dead man's tax records.
As long as it doesn't interrupt me, you can carry on smoking until your lungs look like raisins. But right now, you are interrupting me, and I need you not to. Motherfuck.
Yes, what is it? What do you want?
Greg deals with the balance sheets. That's his job. That's what I pay him to do.
What do you mean you didn't know? He's the fucking accountant. What do you think he does?
I don't care if he's at his niece's wedding. I specifically pay him to deal with this shit so I don't have to. Do you understand? Unless the market crashes, the SFO comes knocking, or the whole office spontaneously combusts, you have no reason to call me here. Okay.
Great. So we understand.
Rough day at the office?
Unintelligent people irritate me. But because some half-wit bureaucrats have decided that workers' rights are a thing, apparently being obtuse isn't proper grounds for termination. Did you know that lung cancer is the leading cause of cancer deaths in women? The estrogen stimulates cancer cell proliferation and advances metastasis. I find it ironic that women are so petrified of breast cancer, yet voluntarily chain smoke sticks of death.
Is this how you usually small talk with women?
Women tend to like men that know a lot about stuff. Saves them from acquiring any knowledge themselves.
And you presume I'm one of those women?
Are you not?
It's not death we're afraid of. It's the lack of control. The feeling that something else is dictating your life. That they can end it if they so wish. Still. If I'm knowingly smoking myself to an early grave, I'll still be able to pick out my casket.
Is that so?
It is.
Women are complex creatures, or so they want you to think. To the untrained eye, sure, they're hard to predict, and they make a point of keeping their thoughts and feelings secret. This makes them feel interesting, like they're hard to figure out, but they're all hardwired the same. Even the educated smart ones would let you choke them to the point of near death and pretend they like it because they think that's what you want to hear. Now how can they expect anyone to treat them with respect if that's how they treat themselves? What they cannot fathom, because they lack the intellect to, is that I'm doing them a favour. They don't want to be on this earth, living this shitty existence. I'm simply doing what they and everyone else are too cowardly to do. Yours sincerely, Apollo.
Oh, sorry. I thought I heard you in your study. I just needed a quick release from your father's office. Staring at the mahogany desk is starting to turn everything red.
Are you sure that's not the man, eh?
Looks like I've been caught red-handed.
I actually just came to retrieve my notebook.
Put something on, will you?
What?
Music. Put some music on, please.
I hate to break it to you, but I don't have any Madonna. Only listen to the greats.
I like the greats.
I mean great classic composers, not greatest hits.
I know. I like the greats. Sebastian Bach. Prelude and fugue in C minor.
You saw the case.
You honestly believe that you're the only one in the entire world who is aware of the greatest and most famous musicians of all time?
No, they're also appreciated by other men, but not women.
Evidently, you're wrong.
Who composed Hungarian Dance No. 5?
Johannes Brahms.
Liebestraum No. 3?
Franz Liszt.
Variations on a Rococo theme?
Tchaikovsky. Are these supposed to be original?
What are Bach's three other variations of Prelude and Fugue?
A minor, E minor, D major.
Wrong. A minor, E major, D major.
You're incorrect.
I can assure you that's not possible.
Well, evidently you're incorrect again.
I've been listening to Bach since I was able to hold a spoon. Trust me on this one. Of course I think I'm always right. I wouldn't try to argue something I think is wrong.
I kill by a code. Anger may often cloud my judgment, but it's important that I stick to that code. My current immediate concern being women. All the greatest downfalls of the greatest men can be seen to trace back to women. Even in a biblical sense, the sinful woman is to blame for many of the world's atrocities. But they simply cannot get away with it anymore. With each day, their superficiality, debauchery, and impurity plague our world and turn us men into blubbering fools. This is why we must test the nature of these women. It should be easy to identify her complete lack of self-respect. We must first be sure of her character, and therefore be sure that she is deserving of her fate. And once you attain your answer, you shall do what you must. Yours sincerely, Apollo.
Hello? Oh, hi, Mother. Yes, I'm fine, but somewhat preoccupied. What are you talking about coming next week? The executor of rules is already here. She arrived a few days ago. Yes, she... What? Are you taking your meds? Because I know sometimes you tend to get a little confused. Well, if she isn't the executor of wills, then who is she?
Good morning. No, I wouldn't waste your energy if I were you. I was in the scouts from age 6 to 18. Those knots aren't budging. Oh, I'm sorry. Did I interrupt your plan? Just when you were about to complete your sacred mission too? Oh, come on. You don't think your whole facade was flawless, do you? You think way too highly of yourself. If even a docile woman has you figured out, you may ought to reevaluate your philosophy. Oh, I can't help myself. I want to know what's going on inside that deluded head right now.
You crazy fucking bitch! Who the fuck are you?
Oh, I'd be careful who you call crazy. Need I remind you who has the knife? As for my identity, consider me your downfall, Apollo.
Look, I don't know who you think I am, but this is a misunderstanding. Just let me go and we can talk.
Except I'm not mistaken. I know exactly who you are, and what you stand for. You may think you've had complete control all this time, but I've been holding every little string. You see, you're not the only one who lives by a code. Like you, I see the plagues in this world. Only you're too blinded to identify the real source. This world will always be doomed as long as it's run by conceited men like you. You've been told for too long that you are entitled to be in control. Who has the power now? Upon hearing your father's untimely death, I saw the perfect opportunity. I'd infiltrate you at your most vulnerable, posing as his executor of wills. Since I'm sure you expected some 40-year-old man to show up at your door, my entrance would throw you off, making all the more disorientated. Perfect time to strike. Still, I had to be sure that you were the right guy, so I waited around until you picked me as your next victim. Which, of course, you did. All it took was the flashing of inches of skin and arguing back every now and then. And I had you wrapped around my finger. Fragile masculinity never fails to amuse me. Oh, and for what it's worth, you were a decent fuck.
Oh my god, you're deluded. Let me go! Right now, you psychotic
people
bitch!
People in glass houses really should have throw rocks. No. Let's come. cut the bullshit and drop the act. I'm sure Apollo has a few questions for me.
How did you know?
I've been following your letters for quite some time now. I must admit, they are quite entertaining. The memoirs of a madman. March 21st, you said your father worked in a high position in banking. April 19th, you couldn't help but ventilate your daddy issues, revealing his untimely death. Respectively, these actions wouldn't have necessarily blown your cover. But what you failed to consider is that this last letter would be published next to the obituaries. The publisher must have had some pretty morbid humour. And there it was. The obituary of Hans Beckett, Vice President of ABC Banking. Loving husband and father to the one and only son, Jack Beckett. You. Now, if that's not the universe giving me a sign, I don't know what is.
No, that doesn't make any sense. I spent years ensuring that no one would know who I am unless I want them to.
You'll be surprised how resourceful a woman can be if she wants it bad enough. The issue is with men that you're used to escaping judgment when the whole of society is designed to protect you. If police really wanted, they could have put you in maximum security by now. But they don't. So you got sloppy.
I didn't get sloppy. You just got lucky. Do not fool yourself. You have no power and never will. You're nothing but vermin. And I swear to God, if you don't let me go right now, I will fucking—
Your delusions of grandeur don't faze me. I see you for what you really are. A weak, insecure man with a desperate need for attention. I'm guessing Hans was a pretty shitty dad, huh?
Do not say his name! You know nothing about me.
Oh, I know everything about you. You're just another strain of a virus. Soon, you will be gone. Eradicated. Left to rot. Just like your father.
That's enough!
April 30th, 1993. Apollo speaking. I used to think I was bulletproof, impenetrable, that I had the entire world figured out. Now I guess I'm not so sure. It's weird how the entire set comes down at once and you realize what you thought was reality is no more than a construction. To Mother, I'm not capable of feeling much, but if I was, I'd be sorry. Sorry for choosing to walk in the footsteps of Father, even though you begged me not to. You were my last hope. To my readers, I'm sorry I fed you a false reality. I'm no god, and I'm afraid I'm now forced to become the very thing I hate the most, a coward. I recently discovered some major flaws in my cover. I'm unsure how long I have left until my real identity is revealed to the public, but even in my ruins, I refuse to let my destiny be chosen for me. My name is Jack Beckett, and I'm responsible for the murder of over 20 men and women. This will be my last letter. Recent events have meant there is no other way out for me. When you unlock the darkness within you, it has a habit of eating up the light. I lost sight of the end of the tunnel a long time ago, and I've just lost my night vision. I have failed you, world. Consider this my downfall.
Yours sincerely, Apollo.